Myself is Professor Praveen Bhandari. Today we are going to understand salient feature of the subject chemical reaction engineering. Why we study or why we should study this subject and how the knowledge obtained in chemical reaction engineering will be useful to every chemical engineer, maybe as a part of his research work or maybe as a part of his job profile. So let us try to understand exactly what chemical reaction engineering is. Now this subject for a diploma course is the part of fifth semester curriculum. Subject code is 22512. Now before we proceed further, let us try to understand what you are going to gain after you study the subject. The core competency which is expected after studying this subject, which we consider as the purpose why we are going to study this subject, is to operate the chemical reactor, to maintain the operating parameters for obtaining the quality products. This is the core competency which we are going to achieve or gain after studying this subject. Now, let us try to understand what is the meaning of this word chemical reaction engineering. So remember, whenever any reactant reacts by certain chemical reaction to give a product, say A is reacting to give you or to give the product P. As an engineer, I am interested to know how much is the time required for converting A into P, number one. Number two, how much is the maximum conversion of A into P? What are the necessary conditions like temperature, pressure for ensuring the maximum conversion of A into P? Or rather, for a chemical engineer, we are more interested in selectivity rather than conversion, because we want the maximum conversion into a desired product, rather 100% conversion into desired product. So for a chemical engineer, it is essential to understand what is the effect of parameters like pressure, temperature, concentration, use of catalyst on the rate of reaction, how fast the conversion of A into P occurs, and can we express that reaction data in the form of mathematical equation. So all these requirements are fulfilled whenever we study chemical reaction engineering. The another interesting thing about this subject is, this is the subject which is studied only by chemical engineers. We often say that mass and heat transfer are core chemical engineering subject or say course. However, mass and heat transfer is also a part of mechanical engineering curriculum. Therefore, since we are a chemical engineer, our identity is because of our expertise in this area, reaction engineering. So before we proceed further, there are some terms which you will be always coming across. So let us try to understand those terms. The first is chemical reaction kinetics. Now what is this? Kinetics, the literal meaning of kinetics is something in a motion. Now in this case, that something is a chemical reaction. When that chemical reaction is in a motion, means what? The reactant A is getting converted into P, that is product P. Now when that A will be converted into P, A will be consumed and P will be formed. Therefore, this chemical reaction kinetics is the branch of chemical science which aims at determination of rate expression . It also studies the effect of operating parameter on the rate of reaction. These are the main objective why we study the chemical reaction kinetics. We also determine the order of reaction and value of rate constant. Now whenever we will be studying the interpretation of batch reactor, that time I will be talking more about what is meant by order of reaction and what is the significance of the value of rate constant. Now just to begin with, chemical reaction engineering is the branch of chemical science which deals with the study of chemical reaction kinetics involving the determination of rate expression, study of effect of operating parameter on rate of reaction, determination of order of reaction and value of rate constant, and use the data obtained for design of chemical reactor. Now the knowledge of this chemical reaction engineering also helps in selection of suitable reactors. And that's why, in order to gain this knowledge, the study of chemical reaction engineering is important. Just to recap, chemical reaction engineering is the branch of chemical science, or say it is one of the course in chemical engineering, one of the core subject in chemical engineering, which aims at the kinetic study, thereby determination of rate expression, studying the effect of operating parameter on the rate of reaction, determination of order of reaction and value of rate constant, using the kinetic data or the knowledge of reaction kinetics for the design of chemical reactor and developing the knowledge and skill to select the suitable reactor for a given condition or for the reaction under consideration. So in that respect, it is very important to study the various aspects of chemical reaction engineering. The another thing is there are number of chemicals which are manufactured into process industry. Every chemical manufacturing can be essentially divided into three steps. Number one, raw material preparation. Next, chemical reaction and third, product isolation and purification. Now this raw material preparation consists of a steps where the physical change is involved, say size reduction, size separation, purification of the raw materials, processing of the raw material in a form so as to facilitate the chemical reaction. All these things are the part of the first stage, that is the raw material preparation, which is essentially the physical change, or which involves essentially the physical change. The last step is the separation of product and its purification. And the middle one, the central one, is the most important step known as chemical reaction, where the chemical change occurs. And the container in which the chemical reaction occurs or which involves chemical change is known as a chemical reactor. It is equipped with the necessary accessories, instrumentation, safety aids to facilitate the safe and efficient reaction. Thereafter, the last stage, that is product isolation and purification, also involves the physical change. However, the first step, that is raw material preparation, essentially consists of mechanical operation, whereas the product isolation and purification step essentially consists of mass transfer operation, and in some cases of course the mechanical operation also. And for this chemical reaction facilitation, it is important to carry out the reaction under proper condition in a suitable reactor, so as to ensure that the raw material, the maximum raw material,